climbing up the escalator. Climbing up the escalator. I feel strong. If you're like an aviator pilot, bet you wouldn't buy it. I'm feeling violent. Bet you're beating iron. Turn up and fly it. Hey, hey, alligator, you've got a lot to learn. I have got a lot to learn. I feel like an autopilot. I'm a rogue song assailant. I feel like a rage coming under my hood. I feel good and calm like a robot. What?
Walt?
Yeah, Mark?
You think that you could spot me $10 more?
Yeah, four.
It's for a friend, Denise. She doesn't have a daddy. He got his throat clipped, you know that.
Your dad?
My dad? Well, he drowned himself at a box for a canyon.
Again?
Again, yes, again. I don't want to get into this. Please. I don't want to get into this.
Actually, I've had a pretty fucked life. I can face reality, so I started doing drugs. And the drugs really fucked up my life. They're really making me feel like shit. When I was doing the drugs, I'd like male prostitute to get my drugs. I like was living with a drag queen, and he always supplied my drugs. I was pulling dates, Fridays and Saturday nights to get my drugs. I was doing quite a bit of drugs. I don't know. You know, when you're in a situation like that, I think street hustling is for material objects only. You know, the kids will like, they need this, so they'll go out and street hustle. And actually that's an easy way to get the money. Because, you know, like let's say I needed food for the night and I couldn't get up money that quick. I'd have to go out and street hustle and get money. I'd have food for the night. And that's the fastest way to do it. That's basically why I street hustled.
$20. Miss, can you spare a quarter?
I'm sorry, it's my last one. Sorry.
What a fucking bitch. You know she has some money too, right?
Look at the fucking meter, man. Anything else better to do that? Hey, brother.
I think we should go up to Seattle, Mike. What do you think?
Yeah.
Yeah! Yeah.
Boom. Wow. Dog shit. It's fucking dog shit everywhere, man. Why can't dogs just shit on the side of the road?
Oh, How about next week sometime? Give me a call!
That receipt.
Okay. Thank you.
Right here. I don't need a bag either.
There you go. Bye-bye.
Thank you. How's that sound? Don't fucking kiss. Is that fair? All right. Friendly Frankie said something about it. Well, if you're on or not. I'm gonna nap right there until you came by. So how's your wife? Good, I take it. You're very talkative.
Burgers are getting cold, Doc. Hopefully, lonely?
My father was a biker, fucking killed some guy in a bar fight, and just took off someplace. I'm never gonna find him.
What's he looking at?
What's up?
I charge you buck a minute, but for you, since you're my friend, 50 cents, huh? What do you say, you want a party?
Not bad at all.
Be polite.
Get out of here. You faggot.
Dude.
The night, I will make it through the night.
They could drop a big old bomb on this piece of shit. You know what we would do?
Survive!
We would meet up with 15, 16 other guys. And it was about 6:30, 7 o'clock right after dinner time. And we'd all take a walk down about a half a mile down Broad Street because it was the only liquor store that would service. So we would walk there and we'd buy a big gallon of Mad Dog 2020. It's like, you know, $3.50 at the time, you know. And we'd all get that and cruise back down to our neighborhood, which we hung out right outside of McDonald's. And we would go in and get big cups of ice, and then we'd go across the street to the school. It was Southern. It became my high school. And we would just sit there with the radio and listen to Frank Sinatra for 5 hours and just get drunk on a gallon of 2020, Mad Dog 2020.
Like that time that you and Bob dressed up as women and went to shoplift at Safeway, and Bad George tried to pick you up, and after he found out, he was so scared that he jumped off into the Willamette River, right?
Yeah.
That's not funny. It's funny to you, and it's funny to me. That's because we were there. But otherwise, it's not funny. Another example. You and Bob were living at the, what was that hotel? What is it called? At the,
Clements Inn.
Clements Inn, yeah. When you were living there, I stopped by that one day when Bud was checking out Bob's gun, 22, standing in front of the mirror, messing around, thinking that he's in gun smoke. And like a fool, he shoots a hole in his leg, right? Now, that's funny. To me, that's funny. And to you, it's probably funny, right? You're laughing. But Digger didn't get it. He didn't give a shit. Huh. Bob.
You know, all my friends on the street just gave him a big ration of shit, man. So I told them they could have killed me. They could have been responsible for my death, you know, by saying it was cool to go with this guy.
Did you ever see that guy again?
Never. Never. I mean, it was real classy, too. He pulls up in his Porsche and he says, "Yeah, I want to make some money." He looks like a real nice guy. He says he's going for his pilot's license and all this shit. You know, a real legitimate looking dude. It was really legitimate, and I fucked up and I went anyway. I was fucked.
Problem.
What am I gonna eat, Mel? What am I gonna do?
I'm gonna take care of you, man. Scott. Mike. Digger.
Mm-hmm.
Why, you wouldn't even look at a clock unless, you know, that's your run. The dials look like the signs of gay bar.
That's the name of steel. So at midnight! Who ripped me off? Bud!
Matches or anything to light.
Oh, look.
Some fire for my smokeable. I don't think I have.
No, I don't. I gotta send my mom a Christmas card. I keep putting it off.
Yeah, I haven't done that either.
Where's your mom?
She's in Idaho.
Really? I used to live in Montana.
Yeah? My cousin. He lives in Montana. Well, he used to. He just died, actually. He hit a tree going too fast. And then, my brother tells me that, that my grandma, well, my cousin Art's grandma, too, that she just died. So that's two in a row.
Death and usually then, comes in threes.
It does. It's funny you should say that, because my brother says shit like that all the time. He says things usually come in threes. So, right, my cousin dies, my grandma dies, and then right after that, her daughter dies. My aunt, she choked on a biscuit. So, within a year, and they were all women, too, but in a year, it wasn't even a year, was it? No, it was more like 6 or 7 months, 5 months. Let's just say like in half a year, three women in my family died in that amount of time. You got a spider on your head here. Yeah. Yeah, they're dead now, dead and gone. My brother used to say really weird shit like that all the time, though.
My grandma was real superstitious like that. One time I broke three mirrors off of this big vanity that she had, and she swore up and down I'd have bad luck for the next 21 years, you know, 7 years apiece. So far she's been right.
She's right.
Wonder if it'll ever end.
My brother said some stupid shit then. stupid shit like things come in threes, money grows on trees. I don't drive Japanese, but you know, he's right though. And the weird thing too is that my lucky number is 3.
Really?
Yeah.
Mine's 13.
9. I used to like 9 a lot. And before that I liked 5. But now it's 3. I don't know why, but.
You know why I like 13?
What?
You know why I like 13?
No.
Because the 13th letter of the alphabet is M. It stands for marijuana, you know. It's also supposed to be a bad luck number, you know. Bad luck is the story of my life, pretty much.
Yeah. That's cool. I don't mind 13. I think if I ever got bored of 3, I would just like put a 1 in front of a 3 and just like, then like both our favorite numbers, our lucky numbers would be 13. But then by then you'd probably be bored of 13 and then you'd have 3. So it's like, we'll just like play musical
switch
numbers.
Up.
Yeah. This is like a dream. A girl never picks me up, much less a pretty rich girl like you.
No rich girls pick you up. Well, I don't know why not.
Well, this is a nice home. Do you live here?
Yes.
It's good. Nice woodwork.
Would you help me off with my coat? There are some soda pops in the refrigerator. Help yourself.
I want to play music. I want to play music. I want to play it my way. I want to produce it. I want to engineer it. I want to mix it. I want to have say on opening bands. You know, I want to pose for pictures, in front of pictures bigger than myself. That's what I want. I want a lot of people to come to my shows, to see me.
Where should we go?
Let's go visit my brother.
You have a brother?
Yeah, I've got a brother, you know that.
Where is he?
Well, I'm thinking that he should be somewhere in the potato state. Last time I saw him, anyway. Doesn't move much. Just sits and jacks off. Paints.
Shut up, Mike.
You suck.
If I'd known it'd be so hard to start,
I wouldn't have stopped it at all.
I've been here before in this road, you know that? Looks like a fucked up face, Scott. Scott, you see what I mean? Hey, let me try this, man. Let me try this. Wait, it's on this side, man. Oh, dude, help me out.
What are you doing, man?
Did I ever show you this picture of you and Mom?
That was taken out at the institution. I don't know, what was that, 20 years ago?
I'm 17, how could it have been 20 years ago?
Is that how old you are? I thought you was older than that. We used to go out to this place on the weekends to see him. I don't know, he was about, what, 1 year old at the time? I hated that fucking place.
Scott, how do you get a kid this young into an institution? What's that for? What's that all about, huh?
What do you ask me? Why they put you in an institution?
What does that mean? I'm asking you, yeah.
Because of Mom. They didn't think she was safe. But we were a family. You, me, and Mom. Where you going?
Turned out just like me.
Huh? Turned out just like... It's a stupid question. I know the answer, but I don't care.
Don't insult me! Don't fucking insult me! Get
your shit! Don't give me any of your shit! Don't scare me!
Don't give me any of your shit!
Don't worry, he'll be all right. This happens every time we get together. You want a drink?
Yeah.
Like those? I paint them for a living. And sometimes the people don't send me the checks when they're finished, so I keep them. You know? I like them. You know, I like hanging them up. They keep me company, you know? you to know the truth about your mother.
I know the truth about my mother.
You don't know the truth about your mother.
I do. I do.
You don't know the truth about your mother. You're so full of shit. You know, she used to go out at night and look for guys when I was asleep. She'd go out to bars and shake her ass at anyone who was interested. That's how she met that guy. You know who I'm talking about, don't
yeah.
you?
Yeah.
That guy from Reno,
I know what you're talking about.
That cowboy gambling fuck. I remember this guy, he worked in one of those big casinos in Vegas. He got fired for fucking with the cards. This guy was a real scumbag. But your mother loved him. She loved him. And she wanted to marry him. But he said no, because he didn't love her. But she had it in her head that she wanted to marry this guy. She wanted to go off with this guy and go somewhere and have a little family and with the little house and the white picket fence and the fucking dog and the station wagon and all that shit. This was her dream. This is what she wanted. Right? Yeah. This is around the time that you were born. You see? Now, your mother had a gun, right? I remember this, right? She had a gun. It was a Smith & Wesson. It was a .38 revolver, right? And she loved this gun. She loved this gun. She would sleep with it. She would sleep with it, right? Once she was in the kitchen with this gun, right? Stir frying the vegetables with it. Stirring the vegetables up in a frying pan. I said, Sharon, what are you doing? She loved this gun. All right, one night she goes to a drive-in movie with this guy. What the fuck was the name of that the movie? Jesus Christ, what the fuck was the name of that?
Real Bravo, right?
Right, it was a John Wayne movie, Real Bravo, right? She goes with this guy to the movie. During the movie, she takes this gun, sticks it in his mouth, and blows his fucking brains out. Right? Rio Bravo playing on the big screen. You got John Wayne on his horse going through the desert. Spilled popcorn all over the front seat, soaking up the blood. That's why she had to leave. And that guy was your real father.
Oh no. Oh no, you fucking lie, man. You fuck with my mind. Every time you say you're gonna fucking tell me, and then you tell me this shit. Fuck you, man! Listen, I know who my real dad is, alright? 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 Alright, Dick! Dick! You, alright? Alright, Richard? Alright, I know! So lay off me and stop fucking with my head!
You know too much.
I don't care.
Sit down. What? I got this a while back. She sent me this.
You're on a fine job. Mom's the family tree. She's working at a fucking hotel. What's this?
I don't know. I
fucking spill and boil. I wanna go see her, man. Hey, Scott. Why is she working in a place like this?
From what I'm told, she works here. It says right here, her name's Sharon Waters, and that's her. And that's me. But you can't tell it's me. There's that crease right down the middle.
No, I can't think of anyone by that name.
Okay,
let me check with the manager.
Yeah. Yeah, check with Sharon.
There was a Sharon who worked here about a year ago, but she split. Saved up all her money and headed for Italy.
To Italy.
Yeah,
she went to Italy.
She took forever to save any cash, but she finally did it. Flew away. Said she was looking for a family. I guess she was Italian. She didn't look Italian, though.
Your mom was Italian?
I don't know. I don't know. I mean, I guess she was Italian. Do I look Italian?
No.
I didn't think so. I guess she was Italian, though.
She left us this address.
Sharon Waters, Via Casoli, 46, Sette Veni, Rome. Mm-hmm. Rome, Italy. She's in Rome, Italy. In fucking Rome, Italy. Excuse me.
Thanks.
Yeah, thanks.
Who's that guy?
What guy?
Guy gave us a ride from Portland?
Oh, yeah, Hans.
What's he doing here? Come on.
I don't know.
Okay, here we go. Thank you. Hi.
Hey.
Hi. Scott. How have you been? Nice to see you, boss.
Nice to see you, too.
Just staying in this hotel?
Yeah, we're in 309.
For a little while.
407.
See you later.
Yep.
Thank you very much for your time and your efforts, sir.
You're welcome.
Italy. Yeah, fucking Italy, man. Fucking Italy.
Mike, I'm extremely excited.
I just got in. Could you please give me some more time and wait your turn?
But don't you want anything to eat? We are ordering room service, yes?
Room service? Yes, room service. I'll take a hamburger, no cheese, lettuce, tomato, onions, no pickles, and a Coke and some large fries. And make that... Wait. Yes, two hamburgers, please.
Okay, I got it. Two hamburgers, no cheese, no pickles, Coke and French fries. Is that correct, Mike?
Yes, that is correct, Hans. Except I've changed my mind now. I don't want anything that I just ordered. What I would like is four orders of fries. And that's all. And a Coke, please.
I got it. Four portions of French fries and a Coke. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Okay, hurry up.
Yeah.
This little piggy went to the market. This little piggy played with suds. This little piggy had a orgasm. And this little piggy had some cum.
Mike?
What?
You want some ice and a Coke?
Yeah, ice and a straw for the Coke, please.
Okay, hurry up.
What size is that?
Large one.
Large?
Right.
It's not big enough. Make it 2 grams.
Okay. Hurry up.
Okay. Yeah.
You look just like her.
Thank you.
Well, well, let's see. You know, before I was selling pieces for cars. You know, I used to be a performer many years ago. Really a great time I had.
Play it.
Yeah, you're right. Make some room. Put out the light. And the music on. Take off my jacket.
Die Seele der Menschen muss in ihren tiefsten Tiefen verängstigt werden. Durch unerforschliche.
Well, that were the old days. Well, well. Whew. How are the hamburgers, boys?
Good, Hans. Sehr gut. I don't think that I have tasted as fine a hamburger as this family tree hamburger.
I'm glad you like it. But tell me, how did you boys get so far? Arnie left you in Portland a few days ago, right?
We rode on our trusty motorcycle.
And what brings you to Idaho? To this exciting family tree inn?
Business.
Business. Business.
Business, yeah.
And what kind of business?
We're selling motorcycles.
I see. Well, it's time for us now to go down to do some business, right? Let's go to the bedroom to create some atmosphere.
What?
Let's go to the bedroom next door.
Bathroom?
Bedroom.
Oh, bedroom.
Okay.
Sorella ci sarai. Mia sorella non la tocchi, hai capito? Portate la birra voi tre invece di fare tanto gli stronzi, eh? La finisco, per forza me ne portate una lattina alla volta, ma dove vi ha trovato vorrei sapere. Ragazzi, voi siete completamente scemi.
Sì,
Tua madre già mi ha passato un par di volte.
Ancora stai a rompere i coglioni con la tua birra.
Tira fuori i suoi soldi, dai.
Cosa sei tua sorella?
Stasera siamo pregati. E dove vai? Dove stai andando?
Dove stai andando?
Guarda che è meglio che rimani qui, seriamente.
Qua. Il tuo amico ha detto che devi stare qua.
Roma è un casino, sul serio.
Roma,
guarda,
casino. Guarda
che cavolo c'è.
Sono andati
tutti perdi 5 minuti, capito? In giro. Veramente, credi.
Lui è andato da quella parte, credi. Ha detto che tornava subito. Quindi
ci avrà messo un po', ci sono taxi, non c'è niente in giro.
Capito? Ha detto che devi stare con noi.
Guarda che tu vai a perdere. Ti metti in un casino per noi, dai.
Non riesci a trovare il taxi in fretta, ci vogliono 5 minuti, aspetta, no?
Aspetta!
Che succede?
So what do they want?
I told them to take care of you while I get a taxi. They're cool guys.
He reminds me of Mike and what's his name?
Gary.
Gary and Mike Bulwer.
Yeah.
Yeah, Mike Bulwer and
it looked exactly
from Beaverton. That guy from Beaverton.
Right.
You know the guy who deals the speed? No.
Frank?
What?
Scusa.
Hi. Is this your house?
What?
La tua casa?
No, this is my uncle's house. But he's not here now.
My name is Scott.
My name is Carmela.
How do you do? How do you do?
Good. An American woman?
Yeah. Do you know her?
Yeah. But is it not true that she lives here?
It isn't true.
No, she left a long time ago. Back to America.
Was she your friend?
Yeah. She lived here and because I wanted to learn English, she taught it to me.
Oh, this is my friend. This is Mike.
Mike?
Michael.
Katmina.
Hi. She knows your mom.
Really? Where?
No, she's...
I'll be right back. I've been so selfish, man. I've been so selfish. Oh, I quit. It's okay. You know that my mother's house was blue. No, fuck, it was green. Blue-green, maybe. Homesick, you know. I'm not the only one, though. I know that. I just want to go back. I'm ready to go back. I'm ready to leave whenever you are. I got you, bro. Stupid. As if I would find her. I really thought, you know.
We have a chance.
Capiche? And I love that about her. Oh. Oh, hi. How are you? I'm doing fine myself. Where have you been? Really? I like your hair color. Does that mean that you like mine? I could change it for you if you'd like. But I won't. Why? Oh, because I'm me. And you're you. Bibbidi bobbidi boom. Put it together, and what do you got? A fucked up face.
Re ancora?
Ancora.
Ancora?
Ancora.
What? Forgot? Ancora?
Ancora.
Hai fame?
No, yeah.
Quanta fame c'hai?
Hai?
Quanta fame c'hai?
Oh, no, that's good.
Ancora?
Ancora. Grazie.
Prego.
Scusa. Family.
Pardon?
Family.
It's hungry. Are you hungry?
Si.
Hungry?
Si.
Quante volte?
No, no. My Italian is not bad.
Italian is good.
Thank you. Hello. What?
Hmm?
What?
That's nothing. I'll tell you a story, huh?
Story, yeah. Tell me a story.
So the story is about a house. And it's a house far away. And in that house live a man, a woman, and a child. Then the child grows up. And the man begins to look her for and to spy her on. And one night, he comes into her bed, and many other nights, and during the day too. And he teaches her all. The woman leaves, and the man and the girl, they stay alone. And then one day, a boy comes, beautiful boy, love, and she begins to make him all the thing she's learned from that man. But she's not bad.
No, she's not bad.
Why?
What's this?
It's inside.
It's inside. You're inside.
You can eat it.
You can eat this?
Yeah.
Why? Ooh.
No.
No?
You can cook it.
You can cook it?
Yeah.
How do you cook it?
Water.
Oh, so you boil it?
Yeah.
Huh. That's a nice story.
Nice?
Nice. Good. If I could tell a story like that, I would.
Hmm?
If I could tell a story like that, I would.
Can you understand what you said?
If I could tell a story, if I could say...
Okay.
Yeah?
I think I fall in love.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Are you really in love?
Huh?
Are you in love?
Yeah.
Good.
I'm gonna take some time off, Mike. I mean, maybe I'll run into you down the road. I fell in love, Mike. Sorry. I'm really sorry we didn't find your mother.
Yeah.
Take care of yourself, okay?
Yeah, I'll take care of myself. You take care of yourself. Take it easy, get out of here.
Come ti chiami? Cos'hai? Che hai fatto?
Non comprendo. No hablar Italia.
Non ti piace l'Italia?
Ah?
Ti piace l'Italia?
Un pochito. Habla in spagnolo. Muy bien.
Bravo. Sai molte lingue.
Ah?
Sai molte lingue. Parli molte lingue. Ti senti nervoso? Leviti la giacca. Leviti la giacca. Fammi vedere il tuo fisico. Vedo che hai un bel fisico. Ecco, bravo.
No, we're in Portland. In the airport in Portland.
That are stored in the head. Then, there are combinations of the two, which is basic inference, which we discussed in a previous program. Taffy has developed categories of questions based on the sources of information Mary just identified. The categories are right there, think and search, or putting it together as the children say when looking at this procedure, on my own, and author and you. During our interview with Taffy, she defined each of these question-answer relationships.
It's interesting because we've started originally with three different categories of question-answer relationships, called one right there, one pick and search, and one on my own. And
I'm old enough to do a lot of things now.
Oh, yeah. I'm doing a lot of things now. That's not funny.
Hey, go, that'd be $3.
Gary. Hey, Gary, what's up, man?
Hey, Michael, how are you, man?
Pretty good, pretty good. I heard something about this, but I didn't think that, you know.
Yeah, well, you know, it's different, cool. You know.
That's cool.
You want a hot dog, man?
Sure, I'll take some dead pig, yeah.
Normally, they're $1, but for you, 50 cents.
Have a hot dog, too, please.
Yeah, I'll be right with you, man.
make him have his way.
Hey, man, that'd be a buck.
All right.
So, I heard you quit smoking.
Yeah. Where'd you hear that from? It's true. I did. I quit smoking. Gee, do you think that, No.
I thought you said you
no,
quit
No, it's cool.
Smoking.
It's cool. I don't... Well, I'll take a drag, huh? Let me have a drag, man.
Here.
A drag.
It's a little mugged, you know.
That's okay. I don't mind the wetness. Nice weather here, huh?
Yeah, you look good.
Thank you. You look good, too. Yeah, I feel so much better since I quit smoking. I feel so much better. I could breathe, you know?
Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, smoke till you drop, though. It's all right.
That's cool.
You'll get around to it one day. You'll learn. I had to learn the hard way.
I quit one thing at a time, you know? One thing at a time.
Right.
How you doing, man?
Pretty good.
What do you need?
I don't know. What have you got?
We have a three-piece special. Shit, it comes with JoJo's. You can even get the secret sauce with that.
Secret sauce with that?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, we even have chicken strips, corn dogs. What do you want?
Well, Gary just fed me, so I'm kind of doing all right. Oh, something to drink, though.
And what's that?
That's it.
I mean, what do you want to drink?
Root beer?
Root beer?
Or no. Cranberry juice.
Cranberry juice?
Yeah.
It's not supposed to be good for female body parts. It's not supposed to be good for...
Yeah, right. It's good for your vagina, what I hear.
Man.
Do you have, like, any, Valium still? Or do you have some Valium?
No. My friend down the street said he can get Percodan.
Percodan?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck, that's good. I got my wisdom teeth coming in. Mm-hmm. And it's like puncturing through my gum.
Oh, man.
It sucks, it's like swelling up.
Yeah.
I think maybe if I like have like a bad like infection, I could get some.
Yeah. I can't leave here though. You can talk to the guy down the street on the corner in a leather jacket.
Yeah?
He's got it, yeah. That's some good stuff.